the splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice.
The Holy Tales.
Hello, my name is Tubby, live here in this wonderful library, and I love to eat books. I live here with my friends, Gumbo and Freckles. Gumbo! Freckles! Come out, come out, wherever you are. Over there, on that great book, is Grand Old Holy. She is really old and wise and tells us wonderful stories when she is awake, that is. Oh, and we love to sing.
And what can I do for you?
Hello, Holy. We want you to tell us a story from the Bible.
Sure, I will. Today's story is a little long, but you must listen carefully. At the end, I will ask a question.
Okay, Holy, we promise.
This story is about King Solomon, a very wise king of Israel. One day, two women came to Solomon's court to solve a problem they had. Solomon asked them,
"Tell me, what is the problem?"
The first woman said, "My lord, we both live in the same house and we both have a baby boy. One night, as I put my baby to sleep, her little boy died. So she came and stole my baby and put her dead baby in its place. As I woke up in the morning to feed the child, I knew at once that the dead baby was not mine. And now she says she did not steal my baby." The second woman said, "Of course I will say that, because this baby is mine. You lie." King Solomon sent for his guard and said,
"Here, take this baby and cut him in half. I'll give one half to each woman."
The first woman, who was indeed the real mother, threw herself at Solomon's feet. She cried, "Please do not kill the baby. Give him to the other woman, but please do not harm him." The second woman said very calmly, "Of course, my lord, you can cut him in half. This way, neither of us will have a baby, and this will solve our fight." King Solomon smiled. He now knew who the real mother was. Handing the baby to the real mother, the first woman, he said,
"Here's your baby. Don't cry anymore. Your problem has been solved."
The entire Israel came to hear the story of Solomon's wise justice. Everyone now knew that King Solomon was indeed blessed by the Lord himself. Over time, King Solomon became known for his wise judgments. I hope you heard carefully. My question is, when Solomon ordered his guard to cut the baby in half, what did the real mother do?
I want to answer this. The real mother threw herself at Solomon's feet and begged him not to.
That is right, Freckles. Very good. Now I'm going back to sleep. Bye-bye.
The whole